Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum. Straight talk about you and your money. Now from the BizTalk studios, here is Gary Kaltbaum.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. I'm Gary Kaltbaum, your host. Hey, thanks for being with us today. Glad you're here, ladies and gentlemen. Happy that you are listening. It's February 13th, 2024. It's Tuesday. And today, the market sucked. And we're going to cover it. Just so you know, we do webcasts every night, and every now and then we'll do one before the market closes, because there's so much we want to show. And what we'll do in these webcasts is the first one we'll say, hey, these are the areas you need to avoid. These are the ones that are breaking down. These are the ones where the complexion is changing, this, that, and the other thing. And then we're going to come back later with, this is the stuff that is the big strength, little less than big strength, the okay strength, and then the crap. So we already did that. So what I'm going to do right now, I'll introduce us, and then I'm going to just go through what I said in the webcast on the markets that had a very bad day today. But I must state for the record, much better than where they were at 3:30. So first, this is Investor's Edge, serious talk on you and everything that affects you, the markets, the economy, jobs, unemployment, taxes, deficits, spending, scams, shams, corruptions, you name it, we cover it. And right now I'm looking at Dwight Schrute bobblehead, and I'm thinking, why is his head going back and forth when the air is not on it? And it looks like a book fell on it, and Dwight Schrute is now bobbling all over the place. If you do not get this radio show in your city, we'll post it at GaryK.com. We'll also post it on our Twitter feed, which is now X. And you should follow us on Twitter. Just go there, put our name in. You can also email us. Just be nice. Remember, I challenged that doofus wimp that emailed me calling me a liar, and we haven't done this and haven't done that. And I challenged him. I gave him 25 to 1 on $4,000. He hasn't emailed me back. Do you know why? He's a wimp. Anyway. Okay. First off, the Dow was down 524 today. But at 327, I'm just getting a number, it was down 750. You got that? The NASDAQ was down a juicy 287 today. At the low, at 327, it was down 387. Bad day. Here is what happened today. They came out with an inflation number. By the way, I'm going to do this as, I want to say this without insulting. I am going to do this in a way that is so easy to understand, and I hope you get it. So, what we have had for a very long time, as interest rates go up, markets have been coming down. As interest rates go down, the market's been going up. And in case you don't know, the interest rate that we follow is the 10-year yield. And back in October, interest rates crashed, went from 5% to 3.7%, and the markets soared. Go backwards to July to October, end of October, interest rates soared. Markets were trashed. So recently, we've kind of backed and filled. Went from 3.8 to 4.2, back to 3.8. Today, we took out the 4.2 pretty easily. This is the 10-year yield. This is what matters to you most when you're buying a house and getting a mortgage and a lot of other loans. Now, I know you're hearing about the Fed and them lowering rates, but they are the Fed funds rates. they don't deal with this 10-year yield. They are no longer, well, they say they're not, printing money and distorting everything. They are not easy money right now, which they'd rather be, but they can't. The reason why they can't is inflation. And as you know, they missed inflation. We believe they caused it. Others don't believe that, but we know better. We predicted it beforehand. And in order to fight inflation, the thought process is you got to raise rates. So they went from zero to, and they're at 5.25-5.5 right now. But the 10-year yield just recently was 3.8. How can that be? Well, because we tell you the free market is a lot more important than them. Remember, nothing personal. They're dummies. They don't have a clue. They don't have an understanding. They got 1,000 analysts that go out and they still can't figure out what's going on out there. All they do is tell us what's already happened while we are able to tell you things because we actually don't have a butler buying our food and a driver pumping the gas in our car. So we watch the real yields, the market, the free market. Let me explain the free market to you. It is the buying and selling at a certain time, at a certain price, at a certain size by speculators, traders, investors of all kinds, all stripes, all size. That's it. And we always follow it. Now, it was a lot tougher when this, I'll be nice, when Jay Powell was printing money. Because you didn't know what his next move was going to be. You didn't know how much. And he ended up distorting everything. And amazingly, gets blamed for nothing and credit for everything. God, I wish I was in that position. So an inflation number came out today. And one would call it sticky. Now, let me explain what they've been telling you on inflation. They have been telling you that inflation has come down. Way down. Well, they're right. The rate of inflation. We went up, I think at the high was 9%. We're back at 3 to 4 right now. That's the rate of inflation. Prices moving higher. What they don't tell you is prices have not come down on so many things and just keep going higher. So if you are buying potato chips, and they went from $4 to $5 in the last 2 years, 25% rise. And now they're $5.10. Well, they're still going up in price, just less so. And there's so many areas that's happening, especially in a lot of food, but also rent, insurance. Education, because governments stick their sleazy, slimy hands into it, and whenever that happens, costs go up. And markets react to this. So today, a number that came in higher than expected. And the bond market reacted to it. Bond market down, interest rates break above range. Stock market gets hit. Simple as that. So, very simple. The market adjusted today to a move in rates. A blunt statement. Do not listen to the perma bulls that are going to come at you and say, oh, it was due. Well, we knew it was due just because of how big of a move there was and how complacent everybody's been. We've been telling you how the extreme complacency in the market. But you never know when. Don't believe the perma bears. They're going to come out and say, see, told you so. Neither knows where the market's going. We don't know where the market's going, but our next line always is the cards coming out of the deck will give us great clues. We already know what to avoid. We've been telling you the areas to avoid. Simple as that. And what happens when the market weakens, there becomes more names and areas to avoid, even more. And the more of that goes on, the weaker the market gets. I've already been asked whether today can be a one-day wonder. The answer would be doubt it. Doubt it. How bad could it get? I don't know. Could in 5 days defense comes and we're right back up? Sure. I don't think odds favor that. I think probably the market's going to have to go through some adjustment here, and we'll let you know. In the webcast, we first started out by telling everybody, well, you still avoid oils. You still avoid gold and silver. That's my music. Up next, we'll go over that webcast and much more. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
I'm Gary Kaltbaum, host of the nationally syndicated radio show, Investor's Edge. We're not just handsome radio people. We manage investors' money for a living, specializing in fee-based discretionary money management. No big commissions, just a fee on the assets that's managed. We also provide a full range of personalized services, including retirement planning, fixed income, and educational needs, all to assist you in achieving your financial goals. Understanding not all individuals have the same needs, we'll carefully evaluate your personal goals to determine a proper investment strategy. If your current approach to investing is not getting you to where you would like to be, call us to make an appointment for a complimentary portfolio review. The number to call is 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. That's 888-422-5559. Investment advisory services offered through Kaltbaum Capital Management.
It's time to switch on the integrator units and get the brain cells working.
You're listening to...
Hey, this promises to be fun.
Investor's Edge.
The last bastion of quality programming.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
It doesn't get better than this.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. So, we just basically went on to say... oils, gold and silver, China, though we have been telling you, acting better off the lows, but it's really going to need to prove itself, still in a void though, with a couple of names strong, regional banks, utilities, real estate, the bond market, and so on and so forth, whatever's not working. Anything below the 50-day moving average, an avoid. Any individual name, any area. And now what we do is we start measuring and scanning and scanning and measuring. How many names? How many areas worsen? Because I can tell you from the webcast that we already did, the metals and mining worsened. Steel, copper, aluminum, all that crap. And so on and so forth. That's how we're going to roll. We've been telling you small caps really trying, really asserting, but need to get above 205 on the IWM. Small caps were down 4% today. Why? Simple. Small caps have a lot of the regional banks in it, which are quasi-bond funds. And if the interest rates go up, they're losing more money. Guess what? The regional banks got hit today. Small caps got hit today. And now instead of breaking out above 205.50, it really is going to need to hold that 50-day moving average right here, and that 190. So we'll call it back in range bound, but couldn't get off the launching pad again. And it's been trying. Versus the big caps, of course. In semiconductors, in the webcast, we went through analog devices, Teradyne, Micron breaking the 50-day, Microchip, Texas Instruments, Kulikian Software, a bunch of names breaking down. We went through financials. Why is BlackRock breaking the 50-day moving average today? Why is Bank America doing the same? Though, at the end, they bounced a little. And that's how we're going to go about things. So very simple to wind it up. Yields up, takes the dollar up, hurts inflation-resistant areas, inflation areas, interest rate areas. Guess what else got hit today? Housing. Do you know Lennar broke out of range yesterday? Fortunately, we did not buy. It tucked itself in like a frightened turtle today. Why? Interest rate spike, perception on housing, housing down. Home Depots of the world, things like that. Housing related, down. So leave no doubt today. You got a little wall in place. How long? Don't know. How much? Don't know. Could it be fleeting? Sure. But what hasn't changed are the areas that are already in bad shape. More names, more areas got roughed up even more today. So fewer and fewer stocks working. And what we do now is our old line. It's easiest to isolate strength when the market's weak. I can tell you, NVIDIA, amazingly, with the NASDAQ down 282, 287 was down $1.20. Advanced Micro Devices, down 30 cents. With the NASDAQ down 287. Broadcom opens up down $37, finishes only down 13. These are the things we're going to be looking for. There were actually a few things up today versus a horrible market. We're going to be paying attention to those, like Japan is strong, like earnings reports like Waste Management. Today came out with BAFO earnings, because garbage is a big business, breaks out to new yearly highs. We'll be paying attention to that. Wingstop, I guess business is good. A new yearly high today, was up $6. With the Dow down 524, S&P down 69, the NASDAQ 287. I'm going to pay attention to that. We're not telling you to buy them, we're just giving you an idea what stuck out today. Because anything that was up today was a sore thumb. Because advanced declines today, 370 up on the New York, 3672 down. 681 up on the NASDAQ, 3460 down. So let's just call this, from your handsome and buffed host, a little bit of a warning shot. But again, we've had some big leading winners over the last 6 to 8 weeks. We're going to watch each and every one of them, see if they stick. If we, NVIDIA today was down 20-something on the open, finished down 1. What does that tell you? These are the things we pay attention to. These are the things we understand. If a stock like NVIDIA, by the way, was down 26 on the open today, finishes only 1, you mean they were buying it while the market's getting trashed? These are the things we want to see, notwithstanding they report earnings next week. And no, it's not a buy here. The buy was at 505 on January 8th when we told you so. So just letting you know, and we've yet to finish our scans today. We did one earlier, and we're going to have to include that really nice pop into the close and whether that meant something. And, of course, there were a lot more earnings reports to come out. I'm noticing Airbnb, only up $4 now. The other part of the equation, all those earnings surprises that gapped up, broke out, we have them one part of our screen. We're going to see which ones don't go down, which ones hold up best, which ones keep going, which ones go by the wayside. Again, these are the measurements. It's not permeable. It's not permabear. It's letting the cards come out of the deck. and let the process go on. And then close our eyes, hold our nose, and pray. Okay. As we've stated, we've tried that many a time, and it does not work. On the big indices, we're going to watch support levels. That's all. Noticing the NASDAQ 100 down to the 21-day moving average. See if it holds. NASDAQ, same thing. S&P 500, same thing. The Dow, held it today at the close. So we already have some symmetry to follow. Where? And we'll keep you abreast. Up next. All right, news of the day. Yeah, we're going to make fun of some things. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
Listening to
America is talking
Investor's Edge.
He's got to be pleased with that. The crowd is just on his feet here. He's a Cinderella boy.
With Gary Kaltbaum.
Comes highly recommended. You're going to feel better if you talk to him.
All right. Do you know Uber and Lyft drivers are going to join a nationwide Valentine's Day strike tomorrow? Just letting you know. Uber and Lyft. So if you are taking your loved one out to dinner, do not call Uber and Lyft tomorrow. If I were the taxi business, I would try and take as much advantage of that as possible. I have not read yet what they are striking over, but Uber and Lyft. And by the way, I believe Lyft reported after the close and is up, wow, 360, 30%? Boy. LYFT. Keep in mind, it's a $16 stock. And keep in mind, the high of the stock when it came public was a measly 89. It's 16. That's a good move for tomorrow. I'm going to have to look at those numbers. Uber, much stronger than Lyft, but Lyft must have said something that the market's happy with. In the news, well, all I can say, good luck to all of us, whether it's Biden or Trump winning the election. That's all I can tell you. The things that are coming out of their mouths, the excuses, the lies from both of them is just, I don't even know what to say. And I'm going to cover them not today. I got other things I want to do, but just utter stupidity. Speaking of utter stupidity, in the news, anybody know who Barbara Lee is? I recognize her. She's a Democrat running for Senate, I believe, in California. She's been in the House. She's calling for a $50 minimum wage, which would mean $104,000 annually to minimum wage workers. This is what we mean by economically illiterate dolts. D-O-L-T. Go look it up. Amazing. Stunning. That this woman doesn't understand how many businesses are out of business. $50 minimum wage. McDonald's out of business. They're all out of business. It's over. Or they're all fired and everything turns to robots. She's been in our House of Representatives. She's running for the Senate. What's with California, huh? Speaking of, well, we're staying on California today. Hey, California, you know what they did? They did a plastic ban. A plastic bag ban. It's backfiring. See, California's ban has completely backfired. to ban single-use carriers. They're now dumping customers thicker and heavier reusable carriers instead, triggering more pollution than ever. Guess what California's doing now? They're trying to come out with more regulations on that also. Just dummies. And the not surprising but depressing news of the day. And it just speaks volumes. Nauseates. But welcome to my world. Nancy Pelosi. Don't know her. Never met her. Nothing personal. A nightmare of epic proportions to you, the taxpayer. I believe she has voted on probably 25 to 28 trillion of our debt, while she is applauded as being this leader of what have you. Well, in case you don't know, her district is San Francisco, which is falling apart at the seams. And as we have told you on this show, she gets interviewed. And not one person who interviews her actually asks one simple question. What are you doing about all the problems in San Francisco? The homelessness, the crime, the shoplifting, people afraid for their lives, the amount of businesses leaving? What are you doing about it? Not one of the interviewers asks her that simple question because they don't want to lose their spot. They don't want to piss off Nancy. If they piss off Nancy, Nancy goes tells all the other politicians, don't speak to that person again. So a journalist that's supposed to hold the power to account kisses her rear end. But here's the most amazing part. At the age of 83, she decides to run again for the House in San Francisco. Nobody's running against her. At least I don't think anybody's running against her. But here's my point. The San Francisco Chronicle, who's supposed to give a crap about the citizens, is endorsing her for another term. They don't have to do that. They can say, like the New York Times just came out this week and said, Joe Biden, don't run. No, we're going to endorse the woman that has done nothing to fix the problems of crime, of businesses running away, of drug use in the middle of the street where people are afraid of for their lives. No, we're going to endorse her. Welcome to the incestuous relationship of media, journalists that don't give a crap about you. Not everywhere. But this is a case in point. I get emails from people in San Francisco every day telling me things. I get pictures from people who live in San Francisco because I've been covering it, as well as Oakland, as well as Portland, as well as New York City, as well as Chicago, and other places. They're endorsing her. A miserable failure. You let me take over San Fran? Give me 1 year. I have that place buzzing. Drug addicts shooting up in the middle of the street? Ain't happening. Homeless, we're taking care of them. Businesses leaving? We'll entice them to come back. But no. Let's endorse Nancy. And that's a little bit of my news today. And why does that matter? We're doing markets, economy, jobs. Well, it matters because it's in a lot of cities. And Gavin Newsom, who's running California into the ground, is going to run for president in 28. Oh, by the way, in 24. Lastly, Jeff Bezos left Washington. Come to Miami, Seattle. He's saving $600 million in taxes by relocating. You see, Washington decided to come up with a big capital gains tax for those wealthy people. How dare they be wealthy? We're going to extract money out of them. Washington just lost $600 million in taxes because Jeff Bezos gave him the middle finger. What have we told you here? Simple. People, business, capital will flow if able to and go if able to the places they're treated best. Florida's no state income tax or capital gain tax. Washington introduced a 7% capital gain tax on sales of stocks or bonds of more than $250,000 in 2022. The people running some of these states are the biggest dumb arses I have ever seen. You attract people by running government efficiently, effectively, and not castrating the taxpayer. And the amazing thing is, these people see it happening in other states, and they keep repeating the same mistake over and over and over again. Who has the easiest way of moving to the wealthy? Go wherever they want. And people will bid for their services. Do you know how many big machas have come to Florida from states with 13% taxes? I think California may be 14 now. If you make too much, how dare you be successful? And up next, we'll head back to the markets. Whatever else comes to mind. I'm Gary. This is the one and only Investor's Edge.
You're listening to...
What are you waiting for?
One, two, ready,
yeah!
Go.
Action! Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum.
And welcome once again to Investor's Edge. And let me preface again. We would rather come on this show and praise the hell out of our leaders. Praise the hell out of them. But you've got a lying sack, Marxist control freak in the White House. Trump just called for, if NATO doesn't pay up, Russia should just go take them out, attack them. What kind of weed is this guy smoking? And I can go back and forth on both of them, just things coming out of their mouth. I know all the talk right now is how old Biden is. I don't care if he's 150. If he keeps taxes low, regulations low, and just gets the hell out of the way. But no. Raise federal spending from 2019 to 2024 from $4.4 trillion to almost $7. Ladies and gentlemen, over a 50% increase in government. In 5 years, spending this year is going to be more than all the frickin' spending in the COVID years. You know, we had to amp up yearly spending because of COVID. It's now higher. And when he comes out and tells us what it's... You do realize they came out with this Inflation Reduction Act, they called it, and they've admitted didn't do anything for inflation. Joe Manchin, who got it through at the last minute... says he was conned. By the way, Joe Manchin votes with them. He now says he was conned. conned by the president. Isn't that great? This is what we want to hear. And then, oh, the cast of goblins. Utter goblins that surround Trump just want to throw up. Goblins, we warned you. Remember, we warned you about Sidney Powell. When the night she went on TV, I said she was lying. The lawyer. And what was the other one? Jenna Ellis. And now you got these creeps. Oh, my God. I'm not even going to mention names at this point. Egomaniacal creeps. And then there's the border. Look what's going on there. The nerve, the grapefruits of this administration to go on TV and for 3 years saying there's no crisis, and now there is a crisis, and they blame it on the other side and that they don't have enough money. They don't have enough money out of $7 trillion. Do you know how much the wall would cost? The size of a pimple on an elephant's rear end. That's how much from the budget. But how dare they do that? And to lie about, oh, we lowered, cut in half child poverty because of a tax credit. And not one journalist takes Biden and says, can you explain how a tax credit takes a child out of poverty? And the list goes on and on and on of the BS being spewed. He took the championship belt from Trump, which is the highest bar ever. And I want to repeat, and this is to you, the people who love Trump, the people of Biden, I don't want to say any of this, but they have taken over. And Trump tells us how conservative he is. $7 trillion later, when he was prez, before COVID. Just remember, socialism and Marxism is about payoffs. When Trump did stupid tariffs and farmers lost their rear end, he took our tax dollars and paid them off. Billions. Sorry, them dogs don't hunt in Gary's home. We gotta just live and let live. Just set conditions and get out of the way. That's all. Low taxes, less regulations. Regulations where need be, but just go away. Anybody, go and Google the words government departments in California. They have like 500 different departments in California. No wonder they're leaking bucks, even though they're taxing the hell out of everybody. It's supposed to be we the people. As I've said to you, go read Jefferson's quotes from over two centuries ago. He predicted all this. He warned us about all this. I guess you get what you pay for, right? We're going to keep covering it. Because I got news for you. Remember what we have told you. And we're not kidding. They've spent $34 trillion more than they were supposed to. And we're on now the fast track. You know what the fast track is? I think the last trillion was a nanosecond. Every year now, $1 trillion towards interest. Interest. And they don't get called on the carpet. I could never last as a journalist. I'd be fired immediately because I piss everybody off. All right, crappy day. Hopefully tomorrow's better. Hey, I got to tell you, Lyft, L-Y-F-T, closed at 12. It's 20. There's got to be some news. I got to figure out what's going on. That's a big, big move. Till tomorrow, you'll have a great evening. Drive carefully. When you get home, do like we do. Quite simple. Make sure you hug your family. Make sure you hug your children. They will feel better. You will feel better. I promise. Peace out, all. Thanks for joining us. Hopefully a better day tomorrow. Bye-bye.
This has been Investor's Edge with Gary Kaltbaum on BizTalk. To listen to past episodes or to get in contact with Gary, go to GaryK.com. That's GaryK.com.